get loose and produce. Alright everybody, how are you doing today? A lot of you guys have been asking about sound design, so we figured we'd do a video about it. However, this is not really a tutorial, it's more like a guide, but I think this will help you get into the right mindset to create sounds. I tried to think about how I personally approach sound design, and I came up with four main topics which I think about while designing a sound. And these topics are texture. So this is how a sound feels if you were to stroke it with your hand. Space. If you were to imagine a sound in three-dimensional space, what position would it hold in that space? Movement, which is the motion within the sound itself. So this could be the actual motion of the sound, or it could be the motion of the filters or vocalizations within the sound. And the last one is color, which is kind of like the richness and fullness of the sound, as well as where it sits in the frequency spectrum. So let's talk about how we can control each of these things. So for texture, let's take a saw for example. If you can imagine it in front of you, it would look and feel spiky, like a saw, obviously. If you ever use sandpaper in real life, you'll know that whatever you're sanding goes from feeling jagged to feeling smooth. The way sandpaper does this is that it breaks down these large jagged edges into many other smaller edges. The longer you sand something, the more edges you create. It's kind of weird to think about it like this, but it's the same with sound design. By giving a sound voices or using frequency modulation and a bunch of other things, you're adding more edges. And eventually, when you add enough edges, things start feeling smoother to the touch. Second point, space. It's important to visualize the actual space that the sound will hold in your mix. And you have to do this while you're designing the sound, because most of the time you'd be exporting things and you kind of lock in the space early on. So you have to think about, is it going to sit in the middle of the spectrum, or is it going to be on the top? Is it wide or is it thin? What job is the sound going to have? So a mono synth, let's say, will sit right in the middle because it's mono. But if you start adding more voices, it'll start spreading. If you start detuning, it'll start spreading. If you add a chorus or reverb or delays, by doing all these things, you're giving the actual sound presence in the space, if that makes any sense. Third point is movement. There are many different movements, like I said before. There are movements that the sound does itself, like go up and down in volume, like a pluck, let's say, which has a volume or filter envelope with a short decay. But there are also movements which will bring your sound alive, like vocalizations. These things are just filter movements, and controlling them will give you that really cool effect. So if you have an organic sound in mind, you have to imagine what kind of filter movement would make that sound and try to recreate it. For example, you want to make that wow sound. So it kind of sounds like a bandpass filter moving from the lower frequencies to the higher frequencies, and then back down. Last point is the color. This is kind of the weirdest thing to describe because most of us don't really see sounds, unless you got synesthesia or something. But the best way I can put it is how harmonically rich the sound is. So if you can clearly discern all the harmonics, then the sound is colorful. If it's super detuned or modulated and you can't really tell what note it is, then it's not very colorful. It doesn't mean that colorful or not colorful are either bad or good. It all depends on what kind of sound you're trying to create. So by filtering, we can take away color, and you can filter in both directions to take away color. For example, if we cut a bunch of low end out, we kind of start getting a noise, which is super important in music, and is completely colorless. Another thing I like to do is look at my sounds on a spectrum from warm to cold. So a lot of my metallic and ringing and higher frequency sounds I look as cold. And a lot of my basses, my low end, my low drums, and my rich sounds, I look at as warm. Anyway, I hope that made sense to you. Of course, this is just how I approach sound design. Doesn't mean I'm right, but it's just something that works for me. And hopefully you can take something back from this and make it work for you. And now that we have the basics out of the way, we can continue doing more of the standard tutorials where we can show you how to design different sounds. As always, if you have any questions, just leave them in the comments or slide into the DMs. Cheerio, mates.